Cavaliers helped forge the bond that became DCI. Don Warren was there at the beginning, but it was 20 years before his Corps' name was first added to the Founders' Trophy. That pace was about to change. It would be an understatement to say that the Cavaliers simply owned the beginning of the new millennium. The Cavaliers juggernaut captured gold in 2000, 2001, 2002, 2004, and 2006. All the components of the green machine were in peak form, and all came out of their corners ready to set new standards. The design team, conducted by Scott Coder, stitched together completely original programs by Richard Saucedo, Brett Kuhn, Eric Johnson, Michael Gaines, and Andy Toth. They created the framework for the seamless integration of sight and sound. Finals, they crushed the second-place Blue Devils by nearly 2 points with the highest score ever, winning a DCI three-peat and earning the Corps' first undefeated season since 1961. Blue Devils returned the favor in 2003, but Spin Cycle garnered a silver medal and is considered by some to be one of Michael Gaines' most creative visual programs.
When Michael Gaines, listen, when Michael Gaines in a meeting, he doesn't say much, but when he says, you know, whatever he says next, you've got to write down and you've got to make it happen. The bond in the bubble when we were whistling, right, in 2004? You know, every James Bond movie, there's always some sort of unique craft. He's coming out of the sky or out of the ocean. Maybe we can do something like that. And you write it down. The members got off on trying new things, being different, still being who they were, the cool guys, right? We don't work too hard, but they freaking love running. They love hard stuff, and they love being unique.
With Michael Cesario's stunning guard costumes complementing yet another groundbreaking visual program, the 2006 Cavaliers engraved their seventh plaque on the DCI Founders Trophy, the fifth in 7 years.
There was a rhythm to the show that built and built and built. By the time they got, they could have sat down and done their nails. By the end of the show, you were like, yeah! The boldness, of course, the color guard, like nobody else. As the great Bruno Zuccoli used to say, it's not just the throwing, it's the catching.
For the Corps' 60th anniversary, former marching members from every year since 1948 came together to perform as the Cavalier Anniversary Corps 888. Tenor drummer Sam Ghiotti called being back on the field with his brothers the greatest experience of his life. A sentiment echoed by all those present on August 8th, 2008. Although now disbanded, the Classic Cavaliers were formed in 2006 to help prepare for the Anniversary Corps, to fundraise, and continue the Cavalier fraternity. The Cavaliers have expanded their reach through indoor percussion, Chromium Winds, and recently, the inspiring opportunities being offered to special needs students through the King Cobras drumline and color guard. But regardless of the form an ensemble may take, or who it may serve, the Cavaliers will continue to place the welfare of the members above all else. It remains the mission Don Warren established 75 years ago. But with Don's passing in May of 2019, the Corps lost its founder, a father figure to generations, and a man who helped shape an entire movement around the world. And while the championship trophies have temporarily become more elusive, the Corps has never failed to produce great performers and great performances. From a neighborhood Boy Scout troop to a world-class musical organization, the green and white have colored the lives of thousands of young men for the better. 75 years later, generations now have shared what it means to be a Cavalier.